Okay, let's continue on. We're going to continue with the prior script. So you can see this prior script is doing quite a lot. I haven't mentioned this, but this reset SF, as we've discussed, is really important when you want to clear out your variables. But I'm not going to use that here because I'm going to continue on with the same cursor object that I was using before. I'm now going to have to create an insert query. And I can do that reasonably easily by just creating one. So I'm going to say insert query equals insert into, and in fact, I can again go back to my SQLite and see, use that command that I used before, just because it's going to be real easy. And I'll use a triple quoted string, because it's going to make it easy for me to put in other types of quotes if I wish. And now I have my whole query. Again, I think I'm gonna just make it a little easier on the eyes here and no wrapping. And as we discussed, the query specifies which columns I'm talking to and the values that I intend to insert. And then I'm gonna say c.execute. And con.commit. You don't want to ever forget that commit. It won't show up elsewhere unless you do that. And I'm going to execute that. And you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to execute it like three more times. And the reason I'd like to do that is that I can go back to my prior query and the SQLite client, select star from IP, and see all those rows are in there. And if I want, I can execute it five more times, and then I'd see all those new rows have been inserted. It's fairly important that you be able to get a visual on what you've done, and using the SQLite client to confirm what you've done is really important. Now, if you're in your SQLite client and you're not seeing the results of what you did in the Python script, the first thing to make sure to do is that you have a commit going in there. If it's succeeding from here, that is, you're not seeing any errors. If it's succeeding, that means it is going into a database. But if you're not seeing it result here, I'm sorry, if it's succeeding and you're committing, you have to make sure to commit, but you can't see it from here, then the likelihood is that the SQLite client and your Python script are pointed at different databases. Again, we can figure this out pretty quickly. Just quit out of SQLite and do a PWD. You can see users David desktop session 5 working files. That's where I think I am there. Here, why don't we just import OS and say OS get CWD. This is the analogous command. And as you can see, it's the same directory. Now, this is important. And this is the independent confirmation that you need that you're working with the same file. Now, again, if you still can't see it, it's probable that you're working with a different database, and it's either in a different directory or it's misspelled. So when I connect to SQLite 3 from this directory, you can see I'm going to data and IPDB, and that's connecting me. Over here, when I created my connection, you can see I'm also going to data IPDB. This is the other thing that you need to confirm. Of course, as I may have mentioned, if you get an operational error, if you're having any problem at all with any of these queries, you know, if I do something stupid like this and I run it, I'll get an operational error, it's usually because there's something wrong with the query. And in that case, you need to just very carefully, like any syntax error, piece by piece, review the query and make sure that it's all correct.